Amen. So we ready to hear a word, but before the word come, let us stand quickly. Amen. Let us all stand. Those of us that already know Bishop. But we ought to, as mothers say, we ought to give the flowers while he yet is.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
All of you can testify that he's a good man.
Yes.
He's a man that loves hard.
Yes.
He's a man that can preach.
Yes.
He's a man that can teach.
Yes.
He's a man that no matter when you call him, he'll answer.
Yes.
He's praying for you.
Yes.
He's praying for me.
Yes.
But we just want to encourage him, so reach your right hand this way. Say, oh, Bishop Tom.
Oh, Bishop
Tom.
Oh, Bishop
Tom. We need a word.
We need a word.
We already know what you can do.
We already know what you can do.
So we know God will give you extra answers so that you can deliver a powerful word. We want you to do it like you do. Preach like no other. Dance like no other. And if you want to sing a little bit, that's all right too. Bishop,
hurry
up. Come on, let's give God a hand. You may be seated. Before he comes, we will hear from the church choir as they come around. Amen. They get ready. Come on, let's encourage them. Amen. One more time.
I'm
name, Savior.
Keep on going. You want to say something? You want to tell somebody, I know he's by your side. Tell somebody else, I know he's by your side. You need your Abraham? Who you know that to know that to know who's your Abraham? Hallelujah. Yes, 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 yes. That you know that he's your everybody. You wouldn't get these mixed up sickness. Because when I think of the goodness that you see, somebody said he was my rent payer, my car loan payer, my money in the bank, my job, my good health, my deliverer, my liberator. Father God, how it pleases you now, God, as we come to this spot, this place in our ministry, doing our ministry, is word time. And God, we ask that you anoint this word as you can only anoint it. Because somebody, God, needs to be made believe on today, God. And Father God, I rest assured that everything is going to be all right. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. But everything will be A-okay in your name. God, I pray right now that you release this man in your presence. That you'll be able to use him one more time until you use him up. Father God, I pray for strength. I pray for peace. Right now, as we come here and make our way through this street. God, somebody came, but they didn't come complete. Somebody has spoken, God, that they need you even right now. God, please deliver and set free in the mighty name of Jesus. God, I ask that you would decrease me now. And you will increase in this servant. Oh God, bring it alive and well in this place.
Yes.
And God, we know you can do it. And we know you're going to do it. In Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
Open your Bibles to the 17th chapter of St. John and see what the Lord has for this house on today. There's a time for release. You know the Lord's been good
to me.
The Lord's been good to me.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Message this morning, look at somebody and say, neighbor, this is the subject. Just park here until you can see where to go. Sometimes, in other words, you got to park on some broken pieces, sanctified, and see what God has for you next.
Amen.
Sometimes you got a park in a dark alley that you know nothing about until God is ready for your next move.
Yes.
But you got to park.
Yes.
You got to take a stand. You got to stand still.
Yes.
You got to see what God is carrying you to, what God wants you to do next.
Yes.
In other words, sometimes precious, you got to just stay there.
Yes. Stay there.
And see what my next turn may be.
Yes.
Not only God want to move you here or there and yonder, God want to open your eyes.
Yes.
And only way God is going to open your eyes is when you become a listener.
Yes.
When you can pay attention to what God is doing. You'll never pay attention to what God is doing until you're able to remove yourself.
Amen.
Can I tell somebody that again? You'll never see what God is doing until you can get your attitude under control.
Amen.
You'll never be able to see why God carried you through certain situations until you can demise.
Come on, be a show.
Yourself.
Yes.
Take yourself. Kill yourself. Kill your flesh.
Amen.
Kill your thinking. Kill your thoughts.
Right, right.
I always believe, ladies and gentlemen, what's in a person is in them.
Amen.
Until God deals with it.
Amen.
You know, you can look wild while you get ready, but until God is ready to deal with it, it won't come to pass.
Yes, Bishop.
Bad is not always bad. It's your season to see what strength you have to God.
Yes. Come on, Bishop.
Anybody here this morning?
Amen.
God has sanctified you.
Yes.
For a purpose in this hour.
Yes.
God has canceled out your past. God has canceled out every devil. God has canceled out every trial for this season for you.
Yes.
But you got the part.
Yes.
Until you see where you're going, take your seats.
Come on, Bill.
Until you're able to see where God is carrying, I know you say, well, preacher, I've been through this and I've been through that. I've been through all kinds of things. Well, that's all well and good, but God was at the end and God is still there right now.
Yes.
Yes. In other words, it's like an appetite. You got to have an appetite to do the will of God. You can always talk about how you don't like apple pie based on a bad dish you had 20 years ago.
I know.
Well, every dish ain't the same.
Say it again, Bishop. You're right.
Now, some put some butter. Some put some spices. Some put some applesauce. Some put some chunks of apple. It has to be how you like yours. I can't hear nobody.
Amen.
But you got to keep on searching, seeking God out where you are. It doesn't matter how you got to this point in your life. I come here today to expedite somebody to holiness. I come here this morning to bring you out of the brokenness. I come here this morning to tell you it ain't all about you. It's about the presence of the Lord in your life. You absolutely has nothing to do with it. It's all about God, because God brought you here for a reason. God brought you to this earth for a reason. Oh, I know you've been exposed and you've been experienced with things in life. Count it a blessing that you made it through it. Count it a blessing that you lived through it. Count it a blessing that God kept you. Count it a blessing. It wasn't ashes to ashes, dust to dust. You made it through it. Now what you going to do about the blessings of God?
Come on, bitch.
Just walk here.
Just part.
And see what the Lord is up to.
Yes.
Every now and then you want to just stroll out to the park.
Yes.
Sit in your car and see how the folks live.
Yes.
Sit in your car and see how blessed you are.
Yes.
And life wasn't as bad as you thought it was. And
yes.
At least you have a car and a home to go to. I can't hear nobody.
Yes.
Oh, you want to be able to see God's glory in your life.
Yes.
Right where you are and get delivered and get free in your spirit. You all be telling the Lord right now, Lord, I'm sorry. I really thought you forgot about me. But God said, no, when you paused, I fault.
That's right. Amen.
You didn't just fall by yourself. See, God is at work in your world.
Yes.
And each one of us have a world. It's all about what we want to do in our world and how We want to solidify in our world. It's all about what you want, but you got to park somewhere and let God work it out for you. You got to park somewhere and tell the Lord, thank you for where you are, when you come to him. Because the Lord that I said, will deliver you from the law. Somebody needs to know that you know that I'm stuck in a rut.
Of the Lord, you can deliver
for yourself. By what you've been through, yes. But you can't deliver yourselves. By what you know of God, yes. You can't deliver yourself. God gotta do it. You gotta let God do it. He'll do it. I heard a long time ago, a writer said, don't let God have to do it. When God do it, may not be anybody left. But when God does what he do, he will get his answer. Oh, by and by. Somebody please say, by and by. Your mission ought to be shared.
Yes.
Your mission ought to be developed. Your mission has an increase in the knowledge and power of God. What's wrong about it? You're waiting on God, but you're not doing anything for God.
Yes.
Say that again. You're waiting on God. But you're not doing anything for God.
Yes.
There's a difference.
Yes, it is.
Oh, you may say, I'm just sitting here. You can't just sit.
No.
You got to be a praiser. A prayer warrior.
Yes. Yeah.
And a deliverer.
Amen.
And the reason you're waiting, God has you protected.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
You're protected on brokenness. Oh, it may not happen when you want it to happen. God is preparing you.
That's right.
Let me take my seat.
Come on, Bishop.
Yes, God is preparing you to be able to take what you couldn't take.
Yes.
God is preparing you to be able to go where you've never been.
All right.
Yes.
All right, Lord God.
Tell somebody no more distractions.
No more distractions.
The only way the enemy can stifle your blessings is to strike you.
That's right.
That's the only way he can get in your home.
That's right.
Is to distract you. This is the only way he can get on your job. You can become distracted.
Yes.
From the promises of God.
Yes, Lord.
See, many of us have not gotten our blessings because we say one thing, but we do and need another.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
I say, we tell God what we're going to do when we ain't got it.
Yes.
But soon we got it, we do something better.
Come on, Bishop.
Hallelujah.
All right, Bishop.
Yes, but.
Tell somebody else no more distractions.
No more distractions.
Even on your brokenness.
Park.
Put it in park.
Yes.
As you put it in park, park yourself.
Yes.
Park your thoughts. Park your mind. Park your sin. Then you either get delivered. Well, no church person tell you that.
No.
And most of them are trying to tell you how to get delivered. They ain't delivered. Don't let them write that false prophet to you.
Yes.
Because we all are sinners.
Yes.
Even with the grace of God.
Yes. Grace of God.
Yes. Come on now. We all have sinned.
Yes.
And become short.
Yes.
Of glory of God.
Yes.
It doesn't mean that you just literally out here sinning.
Yes.
It means it's in your mind and heart.
Yes.
Oh, if I can see her again.
Oh,
if I can see him again.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, if I can make it back to New York one more time. You sound like the crackhead now. If I can get that high one more time, you won't do it again. The devil only allows you to see that one time. And it's up to you to separate it. Delivered.
Right.
It's up to you to say, thank God for this experience I've done now. Because you'll never get it again.
Yes.
It'll never happen a second time. We run around here mindless trying to get what we used to have. It ain't going to happen. It will not work. It will not operate. It will not for it. God allows you to come out keeping you nothing.
Amen.
You're living off of memories.
Yep.
You're living off some knucklehead.
All right.
Thrill. You're living off something that's not gonna happen twice.
All right.
A lot of folks are in miserable relationships trying to do what they used to do and can't do no more. Folk are miserable.
Yes.
Trying to please people you cannot please.
Yes, Lord. Oh,
yes. Cannot please. Miserable.
Miserable.
Target. And we don't know, Lord. All you can talk about is where we used to go. Now you can't catch the bus. To anybody here.
Amen, Bishop.
That love the Lord enough. To tell the Lord, Lord, sorry, I need to get delivered of this. I want to get free of this, God. I don't want this feeling no more. I don't want this thrill no more. I don't want to act like this anymore, God. I want to be able to be used by you. I want my gifts to come to play. Now, what I have in me is legit, God. I want what you made me, how you made me, how you delivered me, God, how you brought me, God, how you stretched me. I don't want my life predicated upon somebody else's life. I want my own life, Lord. I want to be delivered, Lord. I want to be free, Lord. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. I'm sick and tired of being miserable. That's a
knucklehead.
This is how we get on blood pressure medication. This is how we get on all this other stuff.
Amen.
Trying to mesmerize life that won't be no more. Oh, I come here to get somebody to lift up your head and tell the Lord, Lord, I want what you made to me. And this is a great time to get what you have for me. I want my own deliverance. Lord, I don't want to share this anymore. I want my own. And God will give you your own. And don't feel bad when the truth hits you in the face. Accept it and tell the Lord thank you. Accept it and glorify the Lord that we serve. And tell the Lord, Lord, I want to walk away. Not from my assignment, but from my junk. I want to be delivered of all my junk, God, and I can love you like never before. Lord, I don't want to love no man or woman more than I love you. Lord, I don't want to find myself trapped in a divine situation that has no spirit. I don't want to be trapped in a situation of just nature. But I want to love you going and coming. I want to be able to love my brothers and sisters, Lord. But I want to be genuine. Lord, I want you to be the center of my joy. Lord, I want you to be my peace. Because I'm sick and tired of total pieces, and that's all. I want to be able, Lord, to rest for sure that I got peace, and that's enough. I got joy, and that's enough. It reminds me, as I close this message, it was David that said, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He made me to lie down in a green pasture, and he leads me in the sight of still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in a path of righteousness for his name's sake. Please underline that. For his name's sake. He delivered me from the wrong. For his name's sake. I don't know about you. David kept the pen right there. He said, yay. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Oh, God, presence of my enemies. David simply said, when I stand before the Lord and I do the right thing, brothers, you will show me off. You will prepare a table, and all of my enemies are going to the sides. Jesus, you take back everything they said about me. And you will prepare a table in the eyes of my enemies. Oh Lord, because you don't know it yet. My head will fall, and that little cup you give me, it'll run it over. Somebody please run it over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever, forever, and ever. Just park and wait on the Lord. Just park. That's all you got to do. Park and wait on the Lord. You ain't got to run tell nobody nothing. You ain't got to tell the enemy. I'm not seeing now. What now has to do with it?
Glory.
Thank you. What now gonna do with it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
If you really say,
yes, sir.
Just park and let it.
That's right. Yes.
Park.
Yes.
Thank you.
Live it.
Yes.
And wait on the Lord.
Yes.
And He will.
Will.
I say He will.
He will
deliver you.
Yes.
From them all. Come on and clap those hands. Clap them. And tell the Lord thank you. Clap them.
Yeah.
Come on and clap them. Clap them on the Lord.
Yeah.
Today, challenge you. Park where you are and let God do it. Let Him do that which you need. And God will. God will change your mind and your heart. Perhaps you're here today. After hearing this message, you say, Pastor, I want to park where the Lord is. I invite you to come, man, woman, boy, or girl. I invite you to come to Jesus. I invite you to come to the Lord. I invite you to come, man, woman, boy, or girl. Come on, promise to do it. I will do it. God will do it.
Oh, yes, God.
God will do it.
Yes, he will.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The storm is really open. I'm doing it.